Hi, I am Dr. Surinjan Sarkar, veterinarian. About 3 months back, I posted a video saying survivors of canine distemper. After that, many people asked me through comments and messages that how is it possible? How did you save the canine distemper patient? How did the dog survive? I told them that someday I will make a video out of it and tell them my secrets. So today is that day. I want to reveal some of the secrets which I do to my dogs to save from canine distemper. But first let me make it clear that I can save only the stage 1 patients of canine distemper, and that too with only 60% success. Even then it is great, because there are many dogs who die as soon as they get this disease. But I would like to reveal the secret I do in my clinics. You see, what happens when the dog first gets the disease, this canine distemper, first symptom that comes is discharge from eyes. Clear discharge from eyes, maybe some discharge from mouth also or nose also. Then as the time goes by, if the dog did not receive any kind of treatment, then this discharge becomes a little bit thicker. We call it purulent nasal discharge or purulent discharge in our terms. And then another thing that happens is hardening of foot pads, that nose, and there is hardening of paws due to hyperkeratosis. But it may go unnoticed. And another thing, maybe your dog may suffer from diarrhea or vomiting, a kind of diarrhea that does not heal by any medicine. It happens due to secondary bacterial infection. So my line of treatment starts if a patient comes with that nasal discharge or eye discharge, the stage 1. In stage 2, it becomes more that when the tetany starts, stage 2, you will see the seizures, see localized seizures or tetany of the whole body, then it becomes difficult to save. Even then, I have saved a few those patients also, a few those dogs also. But let's concentrate on the stage 1 of canine distemper only. So here is what I do. I generally prefer giving a broad spectrum antibiotic. What I prefer is giving oxytetracycline through intravenous route only, not through intramuscular, because intramuscular route is very painful. Dogs in stage 1 of canine distemper suffer from fever also. But my line of treatment is that I never give antipyretic, not corticosteroid, not even the NSAIDs, that is non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. I do not give any kind of antibiotic Because what happens, if you give NSAIDs, it crosses the blood-brain barrier. And once it reaches the brain, after that, it becomes difficult to save the dog. Your dog, you may prefer giving antipyretic, but the benefit will be only transient, only temporary. Your dog may become a little bit better for a day or two. After that, he will become worse. So never give antipyretic. Immunomodulators, drugs that increases the immunity, vitamins, minerals, and a little bit of cyclosporin too sometimes. I give this to enhance the immunity of the dog, because canine distemper is caused by a virus. It's not bacteria. I give antibiotic just to fight against the secondary bacterial infection. And without any antipyretic drugs. That will mean that if your dog is suffering from fever, it means that your dog's body is fighting against the disease. Since your dog's body is fighting, or our body, if we have fever, our body also reacts against the disease. It engulfs the pathogens to neutralize the attack on body. So if I give antipyretic or fever lowering drugs, then body will stop fighting, and this will make the dog weaker. And this is why dog suffering from canine distemper dies. So if you can give this antibiotic, maybe oxytetracycline, and the immunomodulators such as vitamins and minerals, along with, if the dog's food diet is not good, then I also change the diet. I change to be a more protein-oriented or protein-rich diet. So these are the small secrets which I do to the canine distemper patients. And just because of these, the dog survives, maybe. And since I am telling you this, in the stage 2, where the tremor starts, you can save the dog. How? If you can give, along with all these drugs, if you can give the anti-serum or serum, the canine distemper serum, it is available in some countries, particularly in Brazil, or in South America too. In Mexico it is available. If you can get those anti-serum, then also there is chance of survival. Though in stage 2, some kind of damage will remain forever. Your dog will suffer from some kind of tremor or seizure throughout his whole life. So it is better to save the dog in stage 1. So this is the secret I have. This is how I save canine distemper patients. Hope it helps many of my viewers who are watching. Veterinarians also applies this in their clinics to dogs, maybe it will help.